Dear students and my teacher friends, Namaskar. I welcome you to the presentation and lecture on cerebral white matter. Now the cerebral white matter consists primarily of myelinated axon. Cerebral white matter is made up of myelinated axon, and this myelinated axon, they are present in three types of tract. So first of all, let's see where this cerebral white matter is present. Now here in the figure, the mid sagittal section of the brain is shown, and in this view of the brain here, this is the cerebral cortex, okay, and we know cerebral cortex is made up of gray matter, and just beneath the cerebral cortex, all this region, okay, this region is the white matter. Okay, so here in this white matter, three types of tracts are present, and this tract are made up of myelinated axon. Okay, so see, the first type of tract is known as association tract. For example, over here the association tracts are shown. This one is the association tract, and this one is the association tract, and these are the association tract. Now this association tract, they contain axon, and this axon of association tract, they conduct the nerve impulse between the gyri in the same hemisphere. Okay, so association tract, they contain axon, and this axon propagate or conduct the nerve impulse between the gyri in the same hemisphere. That is the function of association tract. Now here in the second point, now we are discussing about the commissural tract. Now the commissural tract, they contain axon. For example, over here in the yellow color, the commissural tracts are shown. So this commissural tract, they conduct the nerve impulses from gyri in one cerebral hemisphere, gyri in one cerebral hemisphere, to corresponding gyri in the other cerebral hemisphere. So for example, let's say over here, this is the gyri, and over here one gyri. So nerve impulse, this commissural tract, they conduct the nerve impulse from one gyri to another gyri. Okay, and this gyri, they are present. So one gyri is present in, let's say, left hemisphere, and the another gyri is present in the right hemisphere. Okay. So, commissural tract, they are conducting nerve impulse between gyri which are present in different cerebral hemisphere, left and right. Okay. Now there are three important group of commissural tract. One is corpus callosum, and the corpus callosum, for example, over here, corpus callosum. Okay, so this commissural tract is actually the, this one is the corpus callosum. And what is corpus callosum? So corpus callosum, the largest fiber bundle in the brain, and it contains 300 million fibers. Corpus callosum, largest fiber bundle in the brain, and it is having 300 million fibers. Then along with the corpus callosum, anterior commissure and posterior commissure, they are also included under the commissural tract. Okay, so let's see the anterior. So here in this figure you see the anterior commissure. Okay, this one is the anterior commissure. Then the projection track. First, let's say the projection track in the figure, the projection track, they are shown green in color. So these are all projection track. Now what is the role this projection track are playing? What are the function of this projection track? So the projection track, they contain axon, and this axon conduct nerve impulses from cerebrum to lower part of the CNS, and this lower part are the thalamus, brainstem and spinal cord. So let's say this is the upper part. Okay, and this part, we can say this is the lower part. So this projection tract, they are conducting nerve impulse from the upper region to the lower region, okay, or vice versa, from the lower region to the upper region. Okay, so projection tract, they are conducting nerve impulse either from cerebrum to the lower part of the CNS, thalamus, brainstem and spinal cord, or from thalamus, brainstem, spinal cord to the cerebrum. Okay, now the example of projection tract is the internal capsule. So in the figure I am showing you, for example, in this figure, internal capsule is shown. You follow the arrow. This one is the internal capsule. Okay, and this, and this internal capsule, this one, this internal capsule is example of projection tract. Okay, so this internal capsule is the thick band of white matter, and it is containing both ascending and descending axon. Okay, so now I am showing you all the figures. Okay, this figure, okay, cerebral white matter, the entire figure, you see all the names. Okay, and see the position of track, the names of the track. Then in this figure, cerebral white matter, then the association track, projection track, okay, commissural track, then the projection tract. this figure. Okay. Now here, in this figure, see, first point, now what this figure is, actually, this figure is the possible pathway for conduction of action potential in the brain, okay? So here, number one, okay, now this is the, this point, here they are showing the gray matter, the internal one, okay, so this is the internal gray matter of the brain, and here the action potential is generated, here the action potential originated. Now how this action potential is conducted to other part of the brain, okay, so this action potential now travels to other area of gray matter by projection fiber. So with the red color, this one, this red color is the projection fiber, okay, so this red color they have used for projection fiber, so with the help of projection fiber, action potential travel to another area of gray matter in the brain. Then a new action potential is generated and sent to neighboring gray matter by association fiber or association track. So this one is the association fiber or the track, and it is conducting nerve impulse or the action potential, okay, from one gray matter to the neighboring gray matter, okay, from one gyri to another gyri, okay. Then we have commissural fiber. So this one is the commissural fiber, and this commissural fiber is conducting nerve impulse, okay. So action potential is generated and sent to other cerebral hemisphere. So from this left cerebral hemisphere to right cerebral hemisphere, how this action potential is propagating? So it propagates, or the nerve impulse is conducted via the commissural fiber or the track between two different, or we can say left and right hemisphere, okay. So with this 1, 2, 3, 4 point, you can understand all the tract and how and where this nerve impulse are conducted or the action potential are propagating, okay. So with this we have completed the discussion on the cerebral white matter. I hope you have enjoyed this presentation lecture on cerebral white matter, and I also hope that this presentation lecture will be helpful in your exam preparation and also in your studies. My name is Manish Kosti sir. I am from Ahmedabad, India. Bye bye. Namaste.